Hey guys, so this video is going to focus on how to find a missing angle when you're dealing with a transversal with parallel lines, and we're going to take into consideration alternate interior angles, corresponding angles, and things of that nature. So we're given the following lines here that we have. We have two lines that are parallel to each other here. So these two straight lines that go side by side here are parallel to each other. And we have this one diagonal line cutting through here. And the diagonal line is known as the transversal. A transversal is a line that cuts through two parallel lines. And when that happens, it creates some scenarios for us that we are able to use in order to find the missing angles of everything else. So what we're going to do in order to find these missing angles is we're going to use some relationships that we know about angles. And those relationships are corresponding angles, alternate interior angles, and then maybe even using vertical angles and supplementary angles, things of that nature. So first off, if I'm looking, I see that they gave us that angle A up here. Angle A is 70 degrees. Okay, so what we're going to need to do is just based off of that one angle, we need to find everything else. Well, I always like to start with vertical angles. Vertical angles are angles that are opposite each other. So if two lines intersect, the two angles across from each other are called vertical angles. And vertical angles are congruent. They are equal to each other. So if angle A is 70 degrees, its vertical angle is angle D, which means D also has to be 70 degrees. What I can also do at this point here is I can use corresponding angles. Almost pretend if you're looking at this top grouping of angles, angles A, B, C, and D, almost pretend that you can pick up those four angles and set them right on top of the E, F, G, H. And what angles would match up with each other? A would match up with E, B would match up with F, C would match up with G, and D would match up with H. And what we know about corresponding angles is that corresponding angles are also congruent. They equal each other. So if angle A corresponds with angle E, that means those two would be the same. And since angle A is 70, angle E also has to be 70 degrees. Same thing for D. That bottom right angle there would match up with the bottom right angle of H. So D and H would also be corresponding angles. And since D is 70 degrees, H also has to be 70 degrees. All right, so what we're going to do here is we're going to use supplementary angles to then find our other missing pieces here. There are a few different ways that you can look at this problem here, but I'm going to use supplementary angles. So a supplementary angle looks like a straight line, and a supplementary angle equals 180 degrees, right? It's half of a circle. So I'm going to pick any straight line on this figure that I have here, and I'm going to pick this top straight line there. And because it's a straight line, I know that this is a supplementary angle. So everything inside here has to equal 180 degrees. Now, I know that angle A equals 70 degrees. So if all of this here, if angle A and angle B make up a supplementary angle, that means angle A plus angle B have to equal 180 degrees. So if I take that 180 degrees and I subtract away angle A, it's going to leave me with angle B. So if I do 180 minus 70, I get 110. So that means that angle B has to be 110 degrees since B plus A here equals this supplementary angle here. And then from there, we can actually fill in the pieces of everything else, because if angle B is 180 degrees, then angle C, its vertical angle, also has to be 110 degrees. And then after that part there, we can use corresponding angles once again down below in order to fill in the other missing pieces. Angle B would correspond with angle F, and angle C would correspond with angle G. So that means both angle F and angle G have to equal 110 degrees. And then you can see that that has allowed us to fill in the rest of the angles for everything else for this particular drawing here. So just using those relationships again, remember that corresponding angles are congruent to each other, vertical angles are congruent to each other, and supplementary angles have to equal 180 degrees. So any angles inside of those must add up to that 180 degrees. Otherwise, that is it for this video.